I'm Sadie Jones. My new book, Fallout, is about a young playwright. It's set in the 1970s. His name is Luke Konofsky, and he comes up to London escaping a disastrous childhood, and he meets other people who are like him, other misfits who are working in theatre. He learns to write, he falls in love with the wrong woman. It's a story about growing up and making mistakes and theatre. Luke was sitting in his coat, alone on a stair in the deserted vestibule. Leigh stopped in the doorway on seeing him. He had his head down in his hands. She could not see his face. Leigh noticed she was swaying. She tried to decide whether to go past him to the loo or leave. She didn't want to talk to him, but she felt she realized a little slow on the uptake and didn't manage to move her feet before he looked up and saw her. "Hello," he said. His face made her smile, automatic happiness. "Here," said Luke, moving along the bottom step. "Sit down." She went and sat next to him, crossing her arms against the cold. He took off his coat and put it round her. She put it on, getting in a muddle with the sleeves, and he helped her. The coat was big and olive green, warm from his body. Luke put his arm round her, as if that were all right and normal. She didn't want to remember why it wasn't. She leaned into him. "Better?" he said. She closed her eyes. He was very warm. He was always warm, she thought. Always warm and never wore sweaters. Always moving, never there. "Where's your girlfriend?" she asked, through the safety of half-closed eyes. "With her husband," said Luke. "Oh," she said, "yes." Leigh allowed the weight of her body to take her closer to him and felt his other arm go round her. He hugged her quite tightly. Her face was against his shirt, one of the buttons pressing on her temple. Looking up from the position her head was in, their faces were quite close, as if they were lovers and they were going to kiss. His mouth was close to hers. The cold air touched her neck below her lifted chin. "What the hell is going on?" Paul was standing in the doorway. Leigh jerked away, overcome by shame, as if they had kissed. All the things that were in her mind.